Welcome friends, this is Will Whitfield with W3 Productions with a Blender quick tip. I wanted to show you how you can apply your image textures to the principal node without a lot of work. This is done through the Node Wrangler add-on. The Node Wrangler is pretty powerful and on its own and does lots of other things, but this is just one more thing you might not have noticed about it. So I'm going to go ahead and enable that. And I'm using Blender 2.8, by the way. Also, I want, for this example, the Add Mesh Extra Objects. Make sure that's enabled. And you can get materials for your object, you know, through Substance Painter if you have that application, or different places online. I tend to use textures.com, and I use the free account, which lets you get small and medium textures of many materials. And it'll give you the albedo maps, height, normal, roughness, and or metallic, and the ambient occlusion, which we generally don't need for the principled shader. So you would download all those, and anytime you're using this setup, you need the file names to end appropriately. So for example, it will be blah 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 cloth.albedo.png or TIFF or whatever the extension is. Cloth.height, cloth normal.png, roughness.png. It just has to be whatever it is dot the file extension. And you'll see that in a moment. So I'm going to add a new object, mesh extras, teapot. Going to give it a resolution of 10. And make it smooth. Also unwrap it. Now let's head over to the shading tab. Add a new material. You can either use this add principal setup button in the properties, or click on the principled shader and hit CTRL SHIFT T, and then you'll search for the material files you want to use. For me, I want to use all these fine gold materials, so whatever it is, the end has to be albedo, metallic, normal, or roughness for this particular material. And there we have it. It applied that material and added the nodes where they needed to go and grouped them for organization's sake. So just to kind of blow up that setup so you can see a little bit better. Added the mapping nodes and fed that to each of the texture files that I imported. So the height map goes to the normal map goes to the normal map node, to the normal and the principal shader. Roughness to roughness, metallic to metallic, and albedo or diffuse to the base color. If we had a height map, it would create a displacement node that would go to the displacement output, material output. So hopefully you found this helpful and will quicken your workflow. Happy rendering and have a blessed day.